supporters of Dave's Tackle Box.
And hello, welcome to Dave's Tackle Box on Sunday, the 12th of January 2014. Now, tonight's show is going to be dominated pretty much by one story, and that was yesterday's vape meets held at BBC offices up and down the UK and other media centres all across Europe. Now, obviously, it's going to take some time for everybody to pull together details of every meet that happened yesterday, but actually we've done surprisingly well. we've got three, no less than three VTs covering Cardiff, a little bit of Manchester, Newcastle, Birmingham, where I was at. No coincidence, the three places that Dave, Andy and I were. So we've actually got three bits of footage to show you, just to, if you couldn't make it yesterday, to sort of sample the atmosphere a little bit, and if you were there, maybe you'll spot yourself. So it's going to be good. And we're going to just reflect on that, because I've got to be honest, it surpassed my expectations. And my screen just went blank for some reason. Then on the Mac, it just went black. And then it came back. So I want to assume it's okay. Let's start with the titles. See you on the other side. And away we go. So in addition to talking about yesterday's vape meets, we're also going to be having a look at a couple of other stories that have hit the news this week. And there's some little bits and bobs as we go along as well. So without further ado, let's introduce my guest, becoming something of a regular now, my good friend and partner in crime, Mr. Dave Dorn.
Hey, hello. Dave. Are you all right, bunny lad?
Yeah, I'm not bad at all. How was your weekend?
Cold on Saturday. Warmed up a little bit later on, but we'll find out about that later. No, it's actually, I'm like yourself, I'm a tad thrilled at what I think was a very successful day, one way or another. And it's not been a bad weekend at all. I think it's safe to say.
It genuinely has surpassed my expectations. The number of venues that we hit, because it was looking like it was going to be good, but you kind of almost expect that some plans won't come off as expected or something like that, but it looks like we hit just about everywhere that we said we were going to hit, and there were a few surprises as well. There's a clip on YouTube, it's in Hungarian, so I won't bother playing it, but a gathering of Hungarian vapors in Budapest, and they were outside was it HIR or something, was the media, the TV station, and they came out and interviewed them and they made the news and everything, so well done to them.
I mean, when you think about it, you know, that is fabulous. That's Hungary. I mean, this was pan-Europe. Germany went crackers as well. They were all over the place.
That's what I'm loving about it. You know, Steffi has been filling up that Dropbox folder with photographs of, I saw Hanover, Berlin,
Dusseldorf.
I mean, because they were hoping to hit about 15 cities, I think, or something, weren't they?
I suspect they hit a lot.
It's brilliant, isn't it? All from a conversation on VT Talk, what, not 2 weeks ago?
Just before Christmas, so, yes.
Just an idea. Boom.
A viewer comes up with an idea and the whole of Europe jumps on board. And the really, I mean, Steffi's been on Skype the day and can we do it again, Dave, she says.
Well, yeah. Let's make sure that we turn the conversation to that. Because while I was in Birmingham yesterday, there were a few ideas on what should we do next. And there were a couple of ideas thrown into the pot there. So, you know, let's have that conversation before the end of the show. Because I think we've proved that the interest is there. We need to do it, don't we?
I think you're absolutely right. I think there's every chance we're going to see Superman on top of the Tyne Bridge flying a Save Our E-cigs banner. It honestly, seriously, I mean...
Okay, I haven't got Superman in my VT, and it's not the Tyne Bridge, but it's close. You'll see.
We'll see.
I better play mine first, I guess. Dave took his camera to Newcastle. I took my camera to Birmingham. Andy took his camera to Cardiff and has also started collecting footage. And we've got a bit of that footage from Andy as he started editing it up in the Smoke Without Fire sort of theme. And it's excellent. And I think I'm the only one apart from Andy that's seen it so far, and it's well worth it. But I'm going to make you wait for that one. You'll have to put up with mine and Dave's dross before that.
Hey.
All right, Dave's dross. I'm really quite pleased with the footage I got. You will hear this disclaimer a few times throughout the show. Andy got some stuff together, so we had something to show tonight because he knew everybody would be interested. But there's a lot more to come. So when you see Andy's clip later in the show, if you sent something in, it's not on there, don't worry. Don't panic. Now is not the time to panic. The shot he sent me is actually called Cut 1. There will be Cut 2, 3, 4 and so on to follow. And he wanted to stress that.
Yes, he's good. At the moment, he's got a Dyson set to suck all this stuff down. Off
indeed. And there's some rather large files. I mean, I've seen tonight two people asking about 1 gigabyte files to transfer to Andy. And it takes time. And it is the weekend and he's got to edit it all and what have you. But it's a damn good start that we've got to show you. It's worth hanging on till the end of the show for, definitely. But what we'll do, I'll start with mine. Because it took me ages. I have to say, just going to do my own critique on this. Some of the sound quality is not as good as it might be. There was a lot of traffic noise outside the mailbox in Birmingham yesterday. But it's good. It's audible. The people that are talking, you can hear them speak. And sadly, I did an interview with Phil Bennion, the Lib Dem MEP for the West Midlands, and I loused it up. And when I got home, the footage wasn't there. And I'm absolutely gutted about that. So I'll have to see if I can track Phil down and grab him another time, because he was brilliant. He was so supportive. But I did get Nikki Sinclair in the end. So I'll roll that one first. This one lasts about 10 minutes and then we'll come back and have a chat. And then we'll work our way through on a sort of relaxed, casual sort of basis tonight. Yeah. Roll VT. Where is it? There it is. Hope you enjoy it. Standing outside the mailbox now, in glorious sunshine, and
there's more than 30 of us so far. It's just about 11 o'clock now. There's people still arriving. We're getting some funny looks off security guards. I'm not sure how much longer they're going to let us film and carry on here. We're just hopefully awaiting a call from inside the building from Radio West Midlands, who are going to be talking to Vapor Trails TV's very own Davey Malik. So I'll keep you posted.
I'm a West Midlands member of the European Parliament, so we demand a referendum now party. Well, I think it's important to stand up for vapers and the attempt by the EU Parliament to attempt to effectively ban e-cigarettes. I think it's ludicrous interference, and I think it's an interference from the EU that we don't need, and it's unnecessary. I think vaping is a very harmless participation. I think that is effectively, and the people I've spoken to today, that I've spoken to Twitter, people who have wrote to me have said this was their way of effectively giving up cigarettes. They've tried everything else. 20, 30 years they've been smoking, and this is the only thing that's proved successful. And the thing that really bothers me about this, and I think it says it all, the major lobby against e-cigarettes is the tobacco lobby. Yep. And I wonder why. I think that argument says it all, and I think that everyone should be very suspicious of why the tobacco lobby wants to ban e-cigarettes. As from what we can see, from what we can hear today, it seems to be the only proven method of giving up cigarettes. So what happens with the EU, any EU legislation, is something called gold plating, and nation states tend to add a bit more to it. And I think, especially here in the United Kingdom, I think we're the worst country in the EU for that. And when the EU puts their foot in the legislative door, they can't stop. They go on and on and on. So what may be a situation now and what they may be promising may not be what is effectively done when the legislation comes to actually be enacted. I would actually like to take a step backwards. I would actually like the EU to say, hang on a second, you know, there was votes at the end of last year as part of the Tobacco Directive, and that was defeated. I think we need to take one step backwards and look. The US authorities, the Food and Drug Authorities in the US, have said, you know, there's no evidence to show this is harmful. Why don't we liaise with them? You know, again, here is the EU being little Europeans. This is a worldwide thing. Let's have a look at the evidence throughout the world, not just here in Europe.
Well, it's about 11:30 now, and I've stood outside the mailbox still, and there are well over 50 people here now. We're still getting funny looks from security guards, but nobody's actually said anything yet. In actual fact, a couple of the security guards have been seen to be vaping, so that's quite funny. Davey Malik did his interview with Radio West Mids. It was very short, and the guy apparently wasn't very accommodating.
Well, yes, you get the PG, propylene glycol, you have VG, vegetable glycerin. It's basically what you get if you go to a nightclub or a pub or something like that. You will have a fog machine. It's the same thing that goes into that, and it's harmless.
So, well done, Davey, for that. It sounds like he was given a bit of a rough ride. We're just going to mill around a bit now and sort of take in what's going on. There was a guy in Balaclava having a laugh with the dummies in the Armani shop, with the manager's permission, it has to be said. And it's going really well. It's good fun. And let's see what happens next.
Protest use. So what have we got in it?
It's free blends of tobacco.
My name's Dean and I'm here outside the mailbox with the vape protesters just to say that, like, this is what we do. We don't want to smoke anymore. The government basically want us to go back to cigarettes, cause harm to our bodies, whereas vaping, probably not 100% proved yet, but it's not bad for us as smoking. My opinion is they don't want us to vape because they're losing too much tax money. It's going to shut a lot of small businesses that have started up doing the e-cigs, helping people stop smoking, and it's just stupid that people, the government, still want people to smoke. Madness, absolute madness.
We are told what to do, how to live, how to do everything. I want the right to be able to vape when I want, what I want, how I want.
I've been vaping for 3 weeks. Found 18 milligram at the minute. Banana flavour as well, I think it's a favourite. Well, so I also have asthma as well, so I can breathe much easier now. I don't use my inhaler as much.
It's 12:15 and as you can see behind me, there's still plenty of people here. Something in the region of 60 people. It's been great fun, actually. You may have seen that there's a banner attached to the railings on one of Birmingham's busiest roads. We've had no interference, no trouble at all. It's been a fantastic day. And without a doubt, we've raised a bit of awareness, even if it's people just wandering past, wondering what on earth we're doing. It's come to the stage where, barring anything exciting happening, I'm going to put the camera away and just go and have a chat with a few people. It's been great fun, really glad I came.
And vape it, EU. You'll never break it.
I'll go back to cigarettes.
And there you go, that was my offering. I had good fun. It took a long time to edit that today, but I had good fun doing it. And I see that Fury, who, for the benefit of those that don't know, was the guy attaching that banner to the railings. That's basically, I think that is the A38, actually, which joins up with the expressway. It's one of the busiest roads in Birmingham. And it's quite funny, though, because there were security guards, there were even coppers going past, and they thought it was hysterical. So, yeah, that was good. And I just want to say for Fury, because I know he's in the chat room at the moment, I filmed the whole of your little vape off. So get in touch with me and I'll arrange to get that to you. So, so that was my effort. What do you reckon? Not the edit, the event. Did it sort of resonate at all?
Oh, hell yes. Yes. It's fabulous sitting watching all of that and seeing, you know, have you ever seen such a gathering of really happy people?
Yeah, at the last vape meet I went to. Do you know what I mean? I mean, yesterday was at times it was a little bit edgy because we weren't sure what. When I arrived, Phil Bennion was already around because he thought it started at 10, right? And he came to, I think he saw me holding the camera and sort of homed in on me and sort of said, security didn't know you were coming. I've just asked them. And I said, oh, well, never mind. Why, are they going to kick us off? He said, no, I don't think so. But there was a little bit of an edge to it as well, which made it more fun. There was a lot of giggling going on.
Yes.
And, yeah, we were stood on a big paved area between... I don't know how much you know about the mailbox. It's actually being renovated at the moment. So most of the shops, all the designer shops are in the mailbox. Okay. It's the mailbox is where in the apartments above it is where a lot of the Premier League footballers live and things like that. Yeah. So and like the only shops that are still opening there at the moment, apart from the bars and restaurants, is Harvey Nichols. So and which is another interesting story. There was a fur trade demonstration sort of set up just as we were coming to the end. And it was really funny because they set up their posters, you know, those horrific posters that they always have, and they always have a megaphone.
Yeah.
And but because there were only about five or six of them, they were like standing in front of us to take their pictures, which amused a lot of us, actually, you know. Because at first I thought, cheeky buggers, and then I thought, no, I'd have done the same if it was the other way round.
Exactly right. The bit I liked was when that Birmingham police car went by.
Oh, yes. We've got to be due a break, so we'll take our first break, and then we'll come back and we'll talk about some more vape beats.
Why not?
See you in a minute.
Cloud 9 Vaping, sponsors of Dave's Tackle Box.
We're back in the room. Yeah, okay, so that was my effort, my offering from Birmingham. But as I say, it was... I don't know if you found the same as well, Dave. I arrived, I took my iPad, which has got the 3G thing. I was going to be posting photographs to the internet and all the rest of it. I think actually what happened was I looked at my phone about three times all the time I was there.
I had mine in my trouser pocket, which was covered by about 53 layers of thermal protection. Even though Mr. Sutton tried to FaceTime me, I never heard a thing.
Right.
I even felt a vibration. That was because I was shivering so much.
Well, it always goes that way, because you're talking to people and then you're trying to get the opportunity to film something. And I actually got to a point where I thought, okay, I'm putting the camera. In fact, I think I said it on the VT. I'm putting the camera down now and I'm going to go and chat with some people. And because, you know, I was there for the meet as much as the protesting, to be honest with you. And I have to say, when I did go on Twitter, we heard a rumour about Manchester moving people along, and we've got a little bit of that in Andy's footage later. You were at Newcastle.
We were, yes.
Shall we roll your VT?
Well, why not? It's 6 minutes and 20.83 seconds there.
20.83 seconds?
Well, you know, say, that's I like round figures.
I've lost your VT. I found it again.
Good lad.
That was Birmingham. This is Newcastle.
Camera, we're actually stood outside the BBC studios, even now, ready to have a vape meet, because today is the day of hashtag BBC Vape Meet. I'm David Dorn and I'm stood here with Angelica Schneider, who is the prospective MEP for the North East, are you not?
Yes, that's true, for the Liberal Democrats.
For Liberal Democrats, as you've just heard. And I'm so pleased to see you here this morning.
Thank you.
And I know the Liberal Democrats have been very, very busy about e-cigs in the European Parliament. What's your take on the whole thing?
Well, I think it's absolutely amazing. I mean, I know that you've been a part of the campaign who actually led the fight for e-cigs to be available across Europe, freely available. And I think you've had an amazing success so far already, because you managed to turn it around from member states saying we want a pharmaceutical solution and have e-cigs treated as medicines, to the way now that e-cigs are seen as consumer products that need to be regulated for certain standards, but should be freely available across the EU. And I think you've done tremendously well there.
Lovely, thank you for that. John, what's made you turn out this morning?
I'm an ex-smoker of 7 weeks. I've tried everything on the market over many years. I've smoked for 55 years, since I was 11. Nothing gets us off the cigarettes, but that has.
And I say after 7 weeks, you've got a VTR there.
I had that to start.
To start?
I went straight to the very top.
That's probably the way to do it. That's excellent stuff.
And that has stopped me smoking. And I'm very pleased with it. I'm very happy with it. It's turned into a bit of a hobby.
Yes.
It's very enjoyable. It's doing us no harm. It's doing nobody else any harm. Please leave me alone.
Exactly. Well, there you are. There's a message for every MEP and every legislator everywhere. Leave us alone.
All the time. And a proper vape meet it was. People were swapping notes left, right and centre about various different devices they'd been using. There was much conversation going on in all manner of ways.
All right, that's an original K-Fan. K-Fan Light.
And so it carried on for the rest of the time we were there. While we waited for the BBC to come and interview somebody, Angelica Schneider spent quite a lot of time speaking to just about everybody that had turned up. We waited patiently. Very, very patiently, but no BBC. While we waited, I spoke with Kimberly and Darren, two very recent vapers that had only heard about the vape meets the day before.
Now, you've only just heard about the whole campaign to save e-cigs.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
How did you find out about it?
Friend. Actually, the man who we get our vapes from, he shared a link last night on Facebook.
Yes, posted the link last night, yeah, yep. We just had a look at it last night, checked yourself out. Thought we'd come along and show some support.
Brilliant, and you've turned out to support the whole campaign.
Definitely.
To stop e-cigs from being taken off the market.
100%, definitely.
Let me ask you first off, how long have you been using e-cigs?
8 or 9 weeks now.
8 or 9 weeks. And how many cigarettes did you smoke the day before?
Smoke 15 to 20, easy. Now smoke none.
And how hard did you find it to make the switch?
Literally easy. Literally easy.
Yeah, unbelievable. Myself, 25 years without a day off cigarettes. Tobacco, rolling tobacco, 20 cigarettes a day. Picked up one of these overnight, never touched them since. Got cigarettes in the house, see them on a daily basis, not interested in the slightest. Has not been an issue at all.
Fitness is important to both of us. We're together.
I've never ran to the top of the street before. I'm now doing over a mile and a half a day on a treadmill, which I could never have done without these.
I was topping about 2 miles when I was smoking cigarettes. Now I'm four to 5 miles easy, like, so it's a massive impact on our lives and our fitness.
Massive.
And I can still have something, it seems to me, like, it still feeds the habit, and I know that it's brilliant for us. I know it's not harming us either, so.
What a bike, superb. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Superb. And just when we were talking before, you said you'd seen my little punchline.
We did.
Go on, I dare you.
Don't let the bastards grind you down.
Good on you.
And our new couple took advice from all kinds of people. Again, learned about everything that it was possible to learn at a vape meet, because this was a proper vape meet. At the same time, certain of our members took notice of cars that were passing and at every given opportunity leafleted them. Go for it, Cliffy. Cliffy kept on leafleting, we kept on waiting, and one of the presenters departed the studios but didn't have time to talk to us, unfortunately. I spoke to Simon about that and what his feelings were.
Now, Simon, you've turned up here this morning outside the BBC in Newcastle, and you've just seen presenter Sue Sweeney come walking out in a massive rush to go hurtling off to a gig. What's your thoughts?
I think there's a potential there to save millions of lives, and she's just walked past and just ignored us. The potential here to have something groundbreaking.
How long have you been using e-cigs?
I've been on e-cigarettes now for 20 months.
And what sort of stuff are you using?
I started off on the Generation 1, and then I moved on to Generation 2. Now I'm on a Provari and the K-Funds.
Excellent stuff. And how many cigarettes a day did you smoke prior to taking up e-cigs?
Smoking 20 cigarettes a day. I was going to the garage, I was buying a pack of cigarettes, maybe a meal deal, and spending roughly about £10 a day. So I'm saving £300 a month.
That's not bad going. Have you bought anything nice out of it?
Not really. My wife's got all the money.
We tried and we tried and we kept on trying to get the BBC to come out and talk to us, but they wouldn't. So as the time approached 2 o'clock, we decided the best thing to do was shoot off to South Shields to the new Crown Hotel, where we knew we'd get a warm welcome.
And we're back in the room.
There you go.
Oh, and we're echoey too.
Ooh.
Kill the echo, don't need that. Excellent video, if I may say so.
Thank you very much.
I particularly like the way that you scripted that, so Cliffy was in every shot.
I went through all the footage trying to find shots that Cliffy wasn't in. Was it too?
It's doing sterling work there, Russell, leafleting and what have you. I want to talk to you a bit more about this, and I actually forgot something about the Birmingham one, so I'm sorry to do this, but I just wanted to show this. If I just flick the camera, because I think that one will pick it up better. This is a leaflet, which you can probably read the headline, EU, leave our vapors alone. And I think, Dave, you can see that too.
I can, yes.
Yeah? Now, this actually was brought along. It was done by Nicky Sinclair. His picture's on there. And obviously, you know, a lot of the information on here is to do with a political party and what have you. But the header on this is EU leave our vapors alone. The We Demand a Referendum Now MEP has joined with the millions of e-cigarette users across Europe to stand up against unnecessary EU interference, which could see these devices banned. There's a picture of an e-cig. There's a clip there with Jeff Caldicott's, the bit he did in the Express and Star that we were looking at. Yeah. The tweet from Dr. Christian.
Yeah.
And then he gives a little summary here of the issue. And I just wanted to say thank you to Nikki for doing that. You know, I know this is promotion for her political party and all the rest of it, but I just thought that was a little bit up, over and above the call of duty to bring those along.
Absolutely.
They made great handouts for the people that were asking.
Too right. And I mean, when you get that kind of support from the politician, you know you're doing the right thing. I think it's excellent. I did see in chat that there was a bit of a... Yeah, I need to make some apologies. There were points when I thought I was filming and I wasn't. Fingers and all that, and the fact that I'm colourblind. and I couldn't see that the light was red and not green.
In the trade, that's known as a Bennion moment.
Is that what it is?
I was just distraught when I got back because I couldn't wait to look at two parts of that. The two interviews with the MEPs, and one of them was...
Yes, well, John, the guy that was right at the top with Angelica Schneider, who, by the way, is an absolutely cracking person. Aside from being gorgeous, she's got her head screwed on the right way. Her dad is a vapor.
Ah, well, there you go. That might explain some of her interest.
Well, indeed. And she went back with a list of mods. By a long, bless her. If her dad's not paid, she's going to be bankrupt this time next week.
I was going to say, she might not thank you for that.
Well, you never know your luck. But yes, I shot an interview with John right at the end, but actually didn't, thought I was. And also the mascot, Bear, the big Newfoundland dog. I got some footage of him waiting very, very patiently that I was going to use in the cutaway. So there's only a flick of it.
If it's any consolation, I noticed the flick of it. So
yes.
So
so I do apologise for that. I really do, and the fact that the sound levels are all over everywhere. But never mind. We had a great time there. It was lovely to meet up with everybody, and a big shout out to Sprotty, who has crippled himself fishing, because he travelled all the way up from, I think, Grantham it was. And to my everlasting shame, I actually signed an autograph yesterday. It's touched me. Sorry. I thought that was... I'm really, really proud to be part of all of this. I'm so touched by it all. And when Andy's gets played out, if I'm not a bloody great big pile of blubbering tears, I don't know where I'm going to be.
And I tell you, it could happen. It could happen. Because I don't know whether we should show the Andy one, actually. You know, because let's face it, our videos were ace, right? I reckon he's got somebody professional to do his.
He's probably definitely got a professional.
I just before we move on to the Cardiff footage, and like I say, there's a little bit of Manchester in there as well, and there might have been something else. I got chance, literally, it came over to me about an hour before we went on air. I had chance to download it and load it into Wirecast. So I played it through once. But he's got a fair few bits in there. But just before we move on to that, as we were saying about Birmingham, the atmosphere at these sort of gatherings, it doesn't matter where you are or what the purpose of the vaping gathering is, the atmosphere is always brilliant, isn't it?
It was fabulous. I mean, you know, there was conversations going on. There was people learning how to rework and how to coil. There was all kinds happening. They were proper vape meets. Certainly the Newcastle one was. The conversations ranged far and wide about vaping, e-cigs, in all its various different flavours and types. And it was just fabulous to me amongst it all. I know I sometimes sound like I'm gushing, but I really was thrilled. I'm still nursing the semi.
I was going to say I felt very proud, but I'll let you have the last word on that particular subject, Dave. I don't know who he is. Yes, so a certain Mr. Sutton did a little bit of editing and came up with this. So I thought I'd better play it out. Seriously, this was worth the wait.
Today what we wanted to do is we wanted to raise awareness to everybody what vaping is, what vaping means to us.
The government will always say there's not a ban, but it is a de facto ban because they want to regulate the e-liquids down to a ridiculous strength.
We basically want to have the right to choose. Cigarettes kill people, you know, this, as far as I'm aware, and millions of people around the world actually are aware, this doesn't kill anybody.
We are vapers and we're not going to go away, and we're not going to go away quietly. So we're making as much noise as we can on Twitter, Facebook, sending emails, calling the newsroom, saying we are here, come and talk to us.
Today is actually 2 years to the day that I've been tobacco free, and I'm here to do my bit to ensure that one, I can be still tobacco free in 2 years' time, and more than that, that other people have the option to be tobacco free.
We need to make ourselves heard, and we need to do it any way we can, and this is nationwide, trying to get the BBC to notice us and make our voices known to them from our side of it, rather than someone sat in Parliament saying, well, vapers believe and understand that this, that doesn't work.
Today in Cardiff has been a pretty much of a good success. We've been met by Head of Security that passed our press release onto the press office. Somebody from the press office have come down. By all accounts, they're going to be inviting me back when they have a debate on it. He didn't say whether or not that would be a TV debate or a radio debate. We've also had the support from the security team allowing us to actually enter onto the BBC site as well to do various bits and pieces. In Manchester, they were asked to leave the facility. So I immediately got on the phone to Manchester to find out what was happening and going on. It's in regards to the protest outside your building at the moment. The vaping crowd up there has moved on.
Are you filming this, sir?
I am doing, yes.
I think I'm going to have to ask you to leave.
Manchester sublet the site from a different landlord, so BBC don't own the site. So what has happened is the landlord has said we want them off-site, because obviously they haven't had permission from us to protest. So they've gone ahead and they've removed our site to not be sort of taken to court for trespassing. As oddly as that sounds, that's what can happen.
This is going to start the ball rolling, because it's time that we actually get listened to by people who are supposed to represent us, who are supposed to actually be the voice of us in Parliament, you know, in sort of like the European Parliament. This is time for them to start listening.
Most people have written to or emailed or run their MPs. I mean, for instance, right now in Birmingham, there's an MEP with the vapers in Birmingham. And make our voices known to them from our side of it, rather than someone sat in Parliament saying, well, vapers believe and understand that this, that doesn't work. It's about us, people of Great Britain and the world, because this is happening in Europe as well. Just saying, look, come and talk to us and find out from our perspective, not what someone said our perspective is. Manchester BBC have asked the people to move away. Surely they should embrace the fact that there are people that want to speak about a very important issue for people who want to stay on nicotine, don't want to smoke.
This is about me standing up and saying, actually, I want something that I know is not harming me. This, for me, is a solution. And it's about time that people started listening.
I see today as the first of many, and I see today as the beginning, and it's certainly not the end.
And we're back, sorry there, I got caught out by the end of that. And we've got echo, that's how caught out I was. I forgot to click the headphone button. So that was just the first cut that Andy's done. There's so much stuff that he's still got to work through. But he wanted to have something for us to show tonight. So thanks to Andy for that. He's worked all day on pulling that together. And as you can see, it's another quality piece of output. In there were photographs from Germany as well, which Steffi had uploaded. Steffi from DE Talk. And it was just fantastic, because we know there's so much more of it to come. So Andy's going to continue taking this stuff. There's a Dropbox thing, which we'll make sure the details are on the VTTV forum. So forum.vapertrails.tv. And we'll get Andy to put the different drop boxes he's using on there, so you can get your footage to him. And wait to see the next instalment.
Do flood him with it.
Yeah.
Get every last half centimetre of footage you've got up to Andy, because I think it's going to be extremely powerful.
He's taking stills and video. whatever you've got, doesn't matter whether it was done on an iPhone or a high-end pro camera, it'll take a lot. And if not the majority of it, may even make it into the final SWAF thing, won't it?
I think it certainly will, yes.
And let's face it, it's a story.
It definitely is. It definitely is. Very boring was saying in chat there, Dave, that one of the chattier vapers up in Glasgow being told by one of the security guys that the BBC was on lockdown nationwide because they'd heard we were coming. I knew they knew we were going.
Well, I've got to be honest, I was a little bit surprised. I was a little bit surprised at the sort of hostile sort of attitude they had to Davey Mallett when he did the Radio West Midlands thing. And they did invite him up there, but they wanted to do it at 11 o'clock, which is as the meet was supposed to officially start taking place. So Davey said, look, you know, can you phone down? Because I'll be here with the guys. And they said, yeah, fine. They were very late doing it. But the regular presenter was ill. And they had a stand-in, and he was quite hostile. But yeah, I got the feeling that they were maybe on some kind of directive not to engage, which is a terrible shame. We need to take another break because we're getting almost to the end of the show here already. But when we come, yeah, I know it's 2:15. Would you believe? I do want to throw it out there to chat straight after this break. Let's start thinking about what we do next. Everybody wants to do it again. Do we do the same thing? Do we try something different? I've seen a couple of ideas go past in chat. I had an idea pitched to me yesterday which sounded like a good one. Straight after the break, we'll have a talk about it. See you in a minute.
Indeed.
Of Dave's Tackle Box.
iVapor and iVapor Elixir, based in Yorkshire, for your e-cig needs. That's iVapor.co.uk and iVapor-Elixir.co.uk. iVapor and iVapor-Elixir.co.uk, proud sponsors of VaporTrails.tv.
And welcome back. So right, so far tonight we've had a good natter about what good fun yesterday was, and we've seen a bit of footage and told you that there's a lot more of that to come. What I want to do tonight though is, if we achieve nothing else, is to start thinking about how we follow that up. We've actually set the bar quite high. There's a couple of ideas that have been floating around. An idea that was put to me yesterday in Birmingham, for example, was that we hold a series of vape meets, gatherings, you know, sort of in a pub, whatever, and link up by Skype. It doesn't have to be Skype. There are other technologies we could use. But, you know, to basically sort of link up on the internet and see how many people we can get involved in one event. So that's one idea. Dave, you picked one up going past in chat a little bit earlier, didn't you?
Well, yeah, they did say, was it possible to meet outside the Scottish Parliament building? That would also involve the Welsh Parliament building, the Irish Parliament building, the Northern Irish Parliament building, the UK Parliament building, and I think every other kind of offshoot of government might be the next one to go to, because it does rather look as though the BBC is going to lock down every time we go there.
Exactly. That's my feeling too. It's exactly my sentiment. I think we did the BBC now, and I think next time they'll be even more ready for us, and we might not even get the freedom we got yesterday. Now they know what to expect, to be honest.
There's an idea that's just come popping into my head.
Go for it.
Wetherspoons.
Because they boycott vapors.
Yeah.
So we boycott them.
So why don't we go and stand outside every bloody Wetherspoons that we can?
There's plenty of them, isn't there?
Pick the biggest Wetherspoon in every major city and go and do outside Weathers what we did outside the Babe. How does that sound?
I'm liking that idea. Are we allowed to go in for a beer in between?
No, you're not allowed to use them at all. You've got to find a pub that's next door and go there.
So we need to find a Wetherspoons next to a pub.
Yes.
No, okay. Seriously, I like the idea. I like the idea because it has significance. It has relevance.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. So that's the government buildings. Because yes, it could be a council or something. Because, you know, I think one of the reasons the BBC thing was so well supported was everybody had one nearby.
Yes, I think that's important.
And so I like the idea of government buildings because, you know, the local councils and stuff like that, there could be.
Indeed.
You know, so it's okay. I mean, it's not the local councils we're against, but let's remember what the purpose of this is, and it's to raise awareness, to make people say, "What are that lot banging on about?" And then you get the chance to tell them.
Well, that's Wetherspoons straight up, isn't it?
Yeah, Wetherspoons. I'm liking that idea. I'm liking that idea. Somebody there suggesting we could do a poll on the VT forum. Do a poll on all the forums, you know. It doesn't have to be one event, does it?
No.
We could be organising two or three of these, you know, so long as they don't all happen at the same time and on the same day.
Every fortnight or every 3 weeks.
Or every week.
Well, why not? Well, every week, yeah.
You know, because time is of the essence. We were talking yesterday with Nikki Sinclair. And
I'm sorry to laugh, yeah. But yeah. The Furious Fury's put in again. All I'm asking is when.
Doesn't care where, just when.
Disco Des wants to do it at Hooters, I might have guessed. I quite like the idea of Wezzy's. That'll be good. We'll call it Hooters afterwards.
And another idea, just to throw into the pot, Nikki Sinclair, after we did the interview yesterday, asked me, you know, if she, apparently every MEP gets a subsidy to bring constituents to Brussels.
Yes.
And she said it's like €170 or something. She said, but they have limited numbers. She said, do you reckon we could fill a coach? And I said, easy. I said,
of course we could.
Of course we could. And now whether she meant per constituency or something, but if it's not a coach, it's a minibus. Yeah, doesn't matter. I said, yes. Anyway, so I committed. I said, yes. And she said she'd talk to Phil Bennion, maybe because they can pull their allowances, because they get an allowance for this kind of thing, and get a load of people to Brussels. She said it would be a cheap hotel or something. You know, you know, she'd get us over there. What I said to her was, you know, that's a great idea, but we've got to have a purpose for being there. There's got to be something happening, like with the balloon event or something.
Yes.
You know, so we've got to know what we're going to do when we're going to get there. We don't want to just go taking pictures of the mannequin piss, do we? Really?
That's in Brussels.
But if Nikki Sinclair has this allowance, then your MBP does too.
Yes.
Just thought I'd point that out. So, you know, there are funds available to do things a little bit more extravagant if we want. So, yeah, it's thinking caps on then, isn't it?
Absolutely is, yes. Yes, we'll talk a little bit more about this on Thursday, I think.
That sounds like a damn good idea. And I should be back. I should be back on Thursday to hear that too.
Excellent. Good stuff. While I remember, and before I forget, before we run out of time, because we may well do, can I just remind everybody that the ITV programme, the Tonight programme that Chris Choi recorded part of here, is not going out on the 16th. It will go out on the 23rd, Thursday the 23rd of January at 7:30. There's been a delay to the scheduling because of all the floods and what they had to do with that. So that goes out on the 23rd, which, on the bright side, gives them a little bit more time to get more information together and pull it all together, which is all good. So that's the 23rd, not the 16th. And Mr. Choi himself has confirmed this, and I have asked him if he can appear on the show either before, during, or after the night of the tonight show. So we'll see what occurs there. Should also point out that Angelica Schneider, who was in the video up at Newcastle, will be coming into the VT Talk studios very early in February, and we'll be talking to her then. So more information will be available on various different topics, which are probably, yes, we'll find out more by then, and we'll find out exactly where she's at. And now our dad's getting on with all these mods that she's been buying him.
Right, I've got to get a little plug in for a friend here as well, which is not vaping related, beyond the fact that it's relating to the former and the founder of UK Vapers Forum ages ago now, lady by the name of Jackie Plage. Is it Plage?
Plage.
Plage. It is Plage. It's very French, that, wasn't it? Plage.
Coming from Hull, they're never going to go with plage.
That, yeah, I suppose you're right.
It's not going to happen.
It's
happen.
The beach, isn't it, plage?
Plage, le plage.
Anyway, she has a blog. I'll just get it up on screen. Get a pen, write this down. Scribblednot.es. Scribbled notes, in other words. And she's got a blog entry there. She's doing a charity, Sleeping Rough, for homeless people. I haven't got time, and I didn't get time to really dig deeply into this, but there's a link on there to a fundraising page. She's basically going to sleep rough to raise money for homeless people, and I promised a shout out, so there it is. That's scribblednot.es. So get along there and give Jackie your support if you can. She says anything from £1 to £100. Should be absolutely delighted. Now, we've got one more vaping related story that we want to cover tonight, haven't we, Dave?
We have indeed, yes.
And here is an article in the Daily Mail. Right, so let's ignore the irony. I'll read it straight. I'll do this one straight, Dave.
Right? Oh, the irony, how can you?
This is the Mail, right?
The Mail.
Now doctors say e-cigarettes do help you quit and could save millions of lives. Right. So, get this. No, I said I'd do it straight. So why are petty bureaucrats intent on banning them from public places? Yeah. And it goes on, blah, blah, de, blah, de, blah. But the core of the piece that they've written is a doctor who has decided that he doesn't like the BMA stance. Ignore the Elite's branding and stuff on this page. But there's a doctor who's been telling his patients that e-cigarettes are actually a good idea, and in fact, he set up a shop in his surgery and is flogging e-cigarettes to them. So on the face of it, that's absolutely fantastic. It's an editorial line, seemingly, that we've been encouraging the Daily Mail to take ever since they started printing their bullshit. And there's been quite a lot of it. But Dave, you've had a look at it, haven't you? And have, what's the word, gleaned something from it, haven't you?
Well, yes. I mean, I don't know whether, however many people know this, but I used to be in a former life an editor of a national publication. So I do deal with how these things go together, and I have dealt with them quite a lot. One or two of the questions that were posed were, do the adverts bear any relationship to the editorial? And if it's done with a view to selling adverts, then it's got to be flagged as such as advertorial, so no, it's not. The ad salespeople will have done their best to maximise revenue on it, of course. But the thing is, it's the last paragraphs that you actually read in these things to find out what the thrust of it is. And the last paragraph in this is one simple sentence following the penultimate. Has Dr. Ashcroft ever smoked? No, but I keep a few e-cigarettes in my pocket to show patients. I passed them around at a medical conference recently. While doctors recognise the size of the health gain, most don't know a lot about them. And then the telling sentence. One can only hope the policy makers are quicker to catch up. This is the most positive piece we've seen out of the Daily Mail in an awful long time. And I, for one, welcome it. I mean, they've turned on a sixpence. They have. I mean, it's a complete 180 from where they've been. But I'm hoping, against hope, that this kind of flags the future for the media in the UK. One or two people did suggest that they might have heard about the BBC and the fact that the BBC refused to meet us, generally speaking, and therefore they were having a pop at the Beeb. Well, that's good too. I don't care why they've done it.
I could live with that. Hey, as with a lot of this, the other politics of these organisations and their reasonings are not the issue here. We want the result, please.
Exactly.
Interestingly as well, Chris Choi has apparently announced that he'll be reviewing some of the footage from yesterday to see if any of that could be included in his show on the 23rd as well. So
tremendous.
Yes. So that has brought us to the end of the show. It's 10 o'clock, would you believe? Hasn't that flown by?
I do not know. I really do not know why time goes so quickly when we're on air.
I was going to talk about Chris Davies for a bit, so that saved him a caning, didn't it?
Yeah, let's not. I was going to say, you know, my darling wife earlier decided that she wanted to watch Dancing on Ice, and that seemed to go on for about 9 hours, and yet this last hour has gone by in 10 minutes.
Yeah, it's incredible, isn't it? It's incredible. Yeah. Oh, I thoroughly enjoyed tonight's show. It's been great fun. I hope everybody in chat's enjoyed it the same. Keep an eye out. There'll be more stories, pictures, and indeed more VT coming from yesterday's event. Let's get the discussions going on all the forums, okay? It doesn't matter where these ideas come from. They're nothing to do with particular forums or TV shows or radio shows or Facebook pages or anything like that. This is all about vapors. All of the vapors in Europe, all of them, every single one of them, it's about them. So where these ideas are formed and how they get spread doesn't matter. It worked pretty well yesterday, just letting everybody go at it. We ended up with an incredible event. We set the bar high. What do we do next? And that's your homework for this week, guys. It'll be followed up on Thursday on VT Talk by Dave. Before then, we've got Dave, you're on tomorrow night with the Haze Hour. Tuesday night we have Marco with Vapor Scene and DE Talk for our German, I nearly said listeners, I suppose they do listen, but they're viewers too.
Yes.
Wednesday, Team Talk again this week, is it?
I believe it is Team Talk, yes.
I shall do my best to tune into Team Talk again, and VT Talk on Thursday, and then we're back around to me next Sunday. As ever, thank you so much for watching. It's been brilliant, enjoyed it, thanks for watching, say good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Sponsors of Dave's Tackle Box.